G'day viewers, we're going to do a shout out to a young kid who's really enthusiastic about coins, and his name's Tyler. He's doing a project at the moment, and I won't give away too much, but I'll post some photos on our next video that we're going to do as to what Tyler's been doing with all his coins. And actually me and Troy are going to post him off some coins just to help the young bloke out a bit. He comments on all our videos, doesn't he, Troy?
I don't think he's missed a video with a comment.
Yeah, so good on you, Tyler. And we've got a target here for you, and if it's a coin, it's going to be yours. So we'll give you a listen. Hope it's not a sovereign. What's it on the dais, Troy?
We've got 86, 87 on the dais.
Righto.
About there.
And I'll give you a listen on the E-track. That sounds like a penny. 11.38. It's pretty deep too, this thing. Fingers crossed, Tyler.
Yep.
Tyler. I hope you can see this all right, young man. Look at that. That'll be your coin, that. See that? Whoops. There's your coin, and that's where it came from. How cool's that? Let's have a look to see what it is, mate. Oh, well done, Troy. It's going to be... Oh, Tyler, I think you're in luck, mate.
1930.
Yeah, it looks like... You know what this is, Tyler. This is an old English penny. 1907. So that's coming your way, mate. I hope you enjoy that one.
What's that, 110-year-old coin?
Yeah, 110-year-old. Good mathematics, Troy. That's yours, mate, so I'll keep that one aside for you. 1907, how's that? G'day viewers, Cointector and Troy here again. It's Good Friday, Easter long weekend. It's beautiful today. It's going to be about 24 degrees, not a breath of wind, no rain, birds are singing, and hopefully our machines will be singing as well. So we've come back to a bush block. It was an old recreation reserve. We've been over it before, but Troy's got the dais, and we're going to hit it again. And also just a bit of a shout out to a bloke on YouTube called Cutterplug. I think he's an American fellow. I watched a few of his videos about deep silver, so I'm going to take a little bit of his advice today and hopefully find some deep. Righto. I'll try and get out of it. The health.
Incoming alert, Trump's dropping the bomb on us.
Yeah, a $4 million one. I mean, sorry, a $400 million one. Coin there, I can see. At the bottom. Just about to put your hand on it. Nah.
Not that I can see.
In your hand now.
It is too.
Yeah.
Oh, look, it is a silver.
Bullshit, Troy. Yes.
You beauty.
What is it, a florin?
I think that's a florin by the way to that one.
Yeah, I'll just come over here. Well done, Troy. Troy, can you bring some water?
I will, mate. I'll just check the rest of the hole.
Like Melissa Etheridge. Somebody bring me some water. Oh, well done, Troy. Good stuff, mate.
You beauty. Your first florin in a little while.
First silver for bloody Easter Friday. Oh, it's going to scrub up nice too, Troy. You know that. It's going to scrub up beautifully. Oh, yeah. Love digging these coins. These are by far my favourite. 46. There you go, viewers. Poor old Troy. As soon as he gets the coin, I just like tax it off him straight away and do the review on it. But that's pretty good, isn't it, Troy?
For first, it certainly is.
First coin for the day, and we get a...
Love digging a florin.
Well done, Troy. Oh.
A little bit jumpy, 91 to 93.
Oh.
A bit deeper, this one, I think.
That thing cracks me up every time, Troy. Coin, Troy? Yeah.
It is a coin.
What is it? 2 cent.
A little.
Or is it a silver? It's a...
That is a silver.
Is it?
Look at the colour of it. It's like it's almost rusted. Little sixpence.
Oh, you're kidding. It is too. It's a little sixpence, Troy. What is it? 63 or something, is it?
No,
40 something. Let's have a little. Oh god, it's a bit manky. Anyway, that's not bad. We'll have to try and clean that up. I think it's 43, Troy, by the looks of that.
43?
Hopefully the view, hang on, I'll try and wipe it on me. Hopefully the, oh, that just made it worse. Hopefully the viewers can see that, alright? Yeah, I reckon it is 43. It is a good Friday.
Is that a penny or?
Yeah. It's a Commonwealth penny, viewers. Bit scabby looking, but anyway, that's good. That's my first coin today. Troy's got 2 silvers on the board, but a little bit slow starting, but we're picking up, mate. We're picking up. Troy just found that little threepence. 1921, is it, or is that a 4? Anyway, I can't quite make it out. Hopefully you can see that all right. So that's good. He's got 3 little silvers now to my 1 penny. Gotta pull my finger out. Oh, that was good. Found 2 close together. There we go, viewers. 1917, little threepence. So that's cool. Troy found 1, and not far from where he dug his, which was just where he is now. I got that 1 there. So anyway, we'll keep looking. 1242. Fingers crossed. Oh, that's promising, viewers. Out of the hole. Yes. Oh, well, it's a coin, but it's a rue penny. 47. There you go, there's another one for you, Tyler. We'll send you some of these, mate, and for your little project you're doing.
Beauty.
I'll show the viewers this. Old English. I'll try and get in the light here, guys.
I've got one too.
What have you got?
What have I got? I've got a little threepence.
What the?
You're not catching me now. I'm taking again.
Oh, I'm not catching him on the silvers, but we just picked up a couple of coins here again. I reckon I've got another one too. Geez, I'll tell you what, I think that's about my 5th penny. Only 1 silver, and Troy's the other way around. He's got about 5 silvers and 1 penny, so... Between us, we're going alright. Don't really quite know what the date is on that one, but we'll look him up later. Back here again, viewers, and Troy's picked up another little silver. What do you got, Troy?
Another little threepence. 1918.
1918
That's
this
the place
time.
You come from.
There you go. Oh, yeah, there's a plug. Nice little coin, that thing, isn't it? 1918. Have a look at that. And we moved up to the top of the block. It's beautiful on the other side, Troy, that coin.
It is. It's quite a nice coin, that one.
And just where we come to the top of this block, we've been smashing it on the coins. So that's good. Well done, Troy.
Silver number 5.
Shut up. Happy Easter. This is Good Friday. It's Good Friday for Troy. He's found frickin' 6 silvers.
88 we got there.
88, mate.
I reckon maybe another threepence.
Well, knowing you, what else? He's running a new program on the deus, aren't you, Troy?
I am, yeah. I found it on Facebook, so I can't remember who I can credit for that, but...
Credit yourself.
It seems to be going quite well.
Credit yourself, mate. Take the credit. Just missed him, Troy?
Just in there a little bit more, I think.
What I could do when it's like this is go like that and get right in close.
Oh, yeah?
What a good idea.
There it is, I can see him in the bottom of the hole.
Oh, stuff off, mate, it is too.
Little threepence.
Looks you like are it. The silver master today, Troy.
I certainly am.
Get off it, mate.
It's another older one.
Can we do the water trick and then we'll go and
we
put him in the sun?
Can, mate, we can.
Well done, Troy, you're bloody smashing it today. Oh, the back's not bad, but the front...
What's that? Silver number 6. Hey!
think he's getting a little bit carried away.
He's not even half over.
He's getting a bit carried away, this bloke. Oh, God, Troy, I can't even work that out, but it's an older one, maybe 1911, something like that, but well done, Troy. It's good stuff, mate. The back of that coin's not bad.
Yeah, the back looks all right with the king's head on it.
But... well, let's see if we can catch this. Oh, he's got it. You got a worm.
A worm?
Come on, coin.
In that bit?
Yeah, it's in there.
What about that?
Nah, it's in your hand, mate. Yep, it's in there.
There it is.
There it is. Another silver.
Sixpence.
Are you kidding? That's a nice looking coin, Troy.
It is too.
And it's an old one? Yes, it is an old one.
What have we got? 19.
Get some water on that sucker.
I think that's 41, or is it 11? 41, I think.
Yeah, 41 it is. Nice looking coin, Troy. Oh, hello, look at that. That's the coin of the day, that one. How's that?
Good nick, isn't it?
19. Just give it a bit of a so it's not as glary. 41.
That's a Joseph, that one.
Sixpence. Joseph Goodnick, for those of you who know who know Melbourne. That's awesome. What a beautiful coin. I tell you what, it is definitely Good Friday for you, Troy.
Certainly is.
Well done. How many you got now?
What's that? Silver number 6.
A rack off, will you? This new program's working all right.
Certainly is.
Any of yours?
The silvers.
We'll keep looking. Coin, Troy. Yep, penny.
Oh, no. Shilling, I think.
Is that? It is. Yeah, that is a shilling. A silver shilling.
She's a bit crusted.
Doesn't matter. Still silver and it's a shilling.
It's a ram's head.
Yeah.
Can't.
Got some waters?
I'll give you that.
Well, hopefully it comes up all right. Oh, yeah, not bad. Not too bad, Troy. It's 52.
52.
I'll see if the viewers can see this all right. Where's some sun? There's a little bit. There you go. 52 shilling. Well done, Troy.
Very happy with that one. I haven't had a shilling for a while.
Just about on the bloody full house, are you?
I just need a penny and a half penny now.
I've got that.
You've got them?
Another one here, viewers. Didn't film this one. Thought it was going to be a pull tab. It sounded really weird. But anyway, little 1903. English half penny. The back of it's not bad, and yeah. Anyway, we'll keep looking.
Just up there, it is.
What do you got?
A little threepence.
I reckon that's 1920.
1920.
I'll just give the viewers a bit of a quick look. See, now that is strange because we've walked around and around and around this old stump, and sometimes it's just a matter of the way you swing or whatever. Not like that, but you know what I mean. And yeah. Another little coin. I think it's 26 or 20, something like that. We'll look at them later, but there's another coin there, viewers. Back again, viewers, under these trees. Don't know what this one is. 1146. Back here, viewers. I finally got one. And it's in the worst condition of all time. But it looks like an old shilling. I'll go see if Troy's got some water. We can't see the... I'll try and...
It's in the teens or the 20s by the look of that. Possibly up to the 30s, but...
Try and clean him up a bit on my pants. Oh, I can't quite see there, viewers.
I can get that...
Hopefully you can see it okay, but it was getting very testy.
It is.
It's a little one centre, is it?
A little silver.
It's a little silver. You're kidding. Yeah, that's it. Well done, Troy. Another little... Oh, it's a wheat penny one. I mean, wheat penny. A wheat threepence. Come up all right, too. 1941.
41, is it?
Yeah, I'll give the viewers a bit of a look,
mate,
in the sun. That's another good little find there, viewers. Hang on a minute. 41. So Troy's bloody smashing it on the silvers today. He's found about 10 now, I reckon. So that's good. Anyway, we'll keep looking. That one there. We'll have a look at this. Didn't sound too bad, this thing. Oh, and there's me little mate. Now, me and Troy got a theory. Whenever we find our little grub mate, here he is, I'll put him back. We always find a coin when we find him. So let's see if he's still right. Put him back down there. Ooh, sounds pretty good.
There you go.
Well, it's not a coin, but what it is a little tiny Australian Forces badges button. Try and come this way and give you a bit of a look. There you go. That would have been worn on a jacket for a cuff or something like that, but I'll have a look at that later. I'm pretty happy with that, guys. What'd you get, Troy?
1921 Commonwealth.
Really? You bloody ripper.
And I reckon there might be something else in that hole. Are you getting anything else in that hole there, mate?
What the? Oh, yeah, they're crusty as here, aren't they, Troy?
They are.
Oh, you're kidding. It's another penny. Troy?
You got another penny?
Yeah. Got another penny, viewers. You're not going to be able to see it too well because it's a bit crustified. Crustified. I think Dalton used that word. There you go, Dalton. There's a crustified Australian Commonwealth penny, I think it's going to be. Anyway, we'll give him a look later on, but that's good. Back again, viewers. Me and Troy have just detected something really strange, and we need your help to see if you can try and identify it. A yellow mushroom. Just leave in the comments. If anyone, looks like someone's had a big chomp out of it, just leave in the comments if they're any good, these ones, guys. Can you boil them up? What's the go with them? Not sure. You want some, Troy?
I'll be right there, mate. I'll let you test it first.
Children, don't eat these things. They're poisonous. Yeah, we just thought we'd show you that. I won't be licking my fingers after either. I'll probably go jumping fences or something. Righto. It's a bit jumpy, but every now and then it's a beautiful clear signal, and I think that's a little bit what that cutter plug fellow was trying to explain. So I'm going to dig this, and it's pretty deep too.
I've got a signal that sounds just like it here too.
And Troy's got one. Can I have a listen to that one, Troy?
Yeah.
No, that one sounds better. Right, well, mine's out, viewers.
That was mine.
And Troy's is as well?
Oh, I've got a silver.
What? So have I.
Have you?
Oh, you bloody ripper.
Sixpence or threepence?
Threepence.
I've got a threepence too.
Which one? I've got an English one.
I've got...
We got
an
a bloody...
Australian one.
We've got a double header, viewers. Can you bring it out here in the light, Troy, with your little water bottle? I think that's 1900. Bang on. What a beautiful little coin. Look at the condition of that little sucker. Hopefully you can see him all right. Sorry about me big fingers. And Troy's one is a little threepence too, but an Aussie one. 1998. Is that right, Troy?
It is. I believe that's 1998.
There we go. How good's that? We better look around here a bit more, Troy.
Right, Miss. We've got a 90 on the dais, and it's about as nice and as crisp line as I've seen to symbolise a coin on here yet.
That's bloody excellent, Troy. Well, big millipede about to get your finger, mate. Move that bit
right,
of...
centipede there.
Centipede, sorry.
There we go.
Bring him up to the camera. Oh, look at him.
Good one, David Attenborough.
Today we are hunting centipedes.
Yeah. Get your shovel, mate.
We've just missed him, haven't we?
Pop that out and it'll be in there, I reckon.
There it is.
Oh, it's a penny. It's a penny, mate.
That was quite a high tone for a penny.
Yeah, mine was that. Because you know why? They're the English one. I bet you it's an English one.
No, it's a roux.
What the?
That's what I thought.
You having a laugh?
No. What we got? A 41.
Ah, the old 41 one. Let's have a look. There you go, viewers. Took us 3 weeks to get it out of the ground, but... Oh, there's another coin, no worries. I think we must have got easily over 20 coins today out of this area. We were going to move, but why would you? Righto. Well, viewers, Troy just needs a half penny for his full house of coins today. So he's got a florin, a shilling, a sixpence, a threepence, a penny.
We just need the half penny and we've got all the Australian pre-decimals.
So come on, Troy.
Except for a sovereign and a crown, but...
Yeah, but
I've never seen an Australian crown in life anyway.
I haven't seen a bloody sovereign come out the ground yet either, Troy, just quietly. Come on, mate.
So we've got 83, 84, so we're in the right area.
There it is.
It's a sixpence, is it?
Oh, you're kidding. It's a beautiful, another little silver.
Well, I ain't complain about that, but...
Don't complain about that, Troy. I haven't found one of them yet today.
What's that one, a 62. That's why it was a bit lower number.
Jesus, in nice condition. Let me take it over here, Troy. Just show the viewers, there you go. 62 sixpence. That's a bit of a mouthful if you've got a little bit of the... That's a bit of a mouthful if you've got a bit of a lisp. A 62 sixpence, but there you go, look at that. Well done, Troy. I tell you what, he's done good on the silvers today. He smashed me about 13 to 3. So there you go, another one. Well done, Troy. Can we do it? It's a penny.
It's a penny.
Can I do a live de-plug? Here you go, viewers. Now, if there's any skeptics out there that reckon people plant coins, think again. Check this. This is a live de-plug. Plug. There you go, look at that. Penny. G'day viewers, back here again. Now, I need the viewers' help on identifying some random object that I found. What the hell is that? It's like some sort of UFO mushroom thing. It's got like a brass or copper shell on the top of it, and underneath it's got like three legs. We don't know. Troy thinks perhaps those legs fitted inside, say, like of a breather pipe, and that cap was, you know, placed on top to stop the rain getting down, but we're not really sure. So if anyone's got any bright ideas as to what that is, can you please leave in the comments, because I don't know, it's like there's copper aliens landing from outer space. Viewers, we're knackered.
87.
Oh, and while I got you, I found this weird looking thing. It's sealed at both ends, looks like a woman's or a lady's lipstick thing, perhaps, don't know, we'll have a look later. Troy just needs a half penny for his...
Well, there it is. It's just popped out of the plug.
It's popped out of the plug and it's a...
whole penny.
Oh.
Well, actually, a bit light. That might be a...
It's a whole penny, Troy.
What have we got?
I think it's an old one, isn't it? Commonwealth.
Commonwealth. 1920, I think that says.
Oh my God, imagine if it said the other one.
1930. You're right if it did.
It's 1920, Troy.
It is?
Yeah. Well done, that's just out in the middle of nowhere, that. So, one more coin to the collection. We smashed it on the coins. We must have found about 25 coins today, easy. So all old pre-decimal. Oh, we found one $2 coin and a couple of 1 and 2 cent pieces, but apart from that, they've been all old. So there you go.
Well done, Troy.
Viewers, this is our roundup on how me and Troy went today. We've gone over a spot we've been over many times before, but Troy wanted to take the XP dais over, and I think he's pretty happy he did. This is Troy's haul on the left, and he smashed it with the silvers today. And he ran a new program. Troy, while I show these coins, can you just explain what program you used?
A program called Shooter. I don't know if it's a well-known program or not. I just found it on one of the Facebook pages. XP Deus user posted it on one of them, and I programmed it in, and it seemed to do well for me today.
Well, the proof's in the pudding, isn't it? You got 4 pennies there. You got a beautiful florin, 46 florin. Little 52 shilling there. So all up, how many silvers do you get, Troy, for?
13, I think it is.
13. So there's 2. He's got 3 sixpence. Lovely little coins. That program that you had on the dais, Troy, that smashed it today.
It did.
And you've got 8 threepence. So I can't read all the dates. I'll try my best. 41, 21, 16. Looks like you might have 2 16s there, Troy, perhaps. Or is that
it? Could be, yep.
Yeah. Anyhow, you get the picture, viewers, as we go along there. 21, I think that one is, and 19, 12. Another 21, or was that 26? Oh, God, I can't even read them. But anyhow, so that was Troy's haul today, which is really quite good. He was happy as with that new program. So I'll show you what I found today. I was a little bit leaner, but I did pretty good with the pennies. I've got a couple of old English ones there. That 1907 one, I'll be sending that to Tyler. So Tyler, that's your coin, mate. You can put that on your project that you're doing, and we'll show the viewers that later. I'll take some photos and they can have a look. So that was pretty cool. I think I found 5 pennies all up, a couple little half pennies, found a $2 coin. Now I do believe that's an old 1910 Australian shilling, Troy.
I think that's what it was, 1910.
Yeah.
First year of the shillings.
A little bit sad on the back, and I found an old English threepence. Just try and get a bit closer there. I think it was 1900, Troy, that.
I think so, the English one, yep.
Yeah, and I found another, I think it's 1917, a little threepence as well. So that was all pretty cool, and some of the little relics that we found. I found this cool little military button. Hopefully that's focused in okay there for you, viewers. That was pretty cool. That was coming up like a penny signal. So,
and without a clean up, it's one of the better condition ones I've ever seen.
Yeah,
the ground.
Not bad, that is it, Troy. It's actually in pretty good condition. So, Australian military forces, I think it'd say there, Troy. So that was pretty good. And a couple of the relics. Got this big piece of copper that was screaming. We thought that might have been a florin or something, but it wasn't. And what we're going to do is keep our copper for petrol money. I think we used to just discard it, Troy, but
we have been.
We're going to keep it now. We do believe this is a lady's lipstick container. It's sort of sealed at both ends, so it's not a cartridge of any sort. So that was pretty cool, little find. And the weirdest thing I think I found was this metallic mushroom thing, whatever it is. Got no idea what it is. So if anyone has, can you leave in the comments what they may think? It's quite large, and on the bottom, it's got these 3 random feet. We got no idea what it is, Troy, do we?
I'm not real sure on that one.
Anyhow, viewers, if you know what that is, just leave it in the comments what you think that may be. But all in all, pretty good, and I think Troy, he's the winner today for sure with the silvers, and I think you might be sticking to that program, Troy.
I'll run it for a little while now, I think. I'll see how it goes.
Yeah, so anyway, it's Good Friday, Easter long weekend, and happy Easter to everyone. Be safe on the roads, and we'll see you next time for some more adventures with Cointector and Troy.